This is One-on-One with Jane Mitchell.
In this edition, Behind the Plate with Ramon Hernandez. And Behind Closed Doors with Ryan Klesko.
Closet envy here.
I love to shop for shoes on the road.
Ryan Klesko and Ramon Hernandez, two guys with all-star and postseason play on their resumes. They have big personalities, and when it comes to the game and kids, even bigger hearts. We begin with number 55, Ramon Hernandez. Ramon Hernandez in 2004, an all-star catcher acquired in an off-season trade with the American League Oakland A's. And like the salsa music he loves, he's vibrant, confident, consistent, and one of the most durable catchers in the game today. With a respected rapport and command of the pitching staff, he has worked equally hard at having command of his second language, English.
Especially our team, you got guys from Alabama, they got the U-O-L, and you got guys from New York. You got guys from New York, they like, you know. So it's, Joe, it's a different stuff that you get to learn, especially when you're on a baseball team, because you get people from everywhere. When the season starts going and you get April, May, I guess my tongue is getting a little bit looser, so I can't say the words.
He has quite the sense of humor, and at 28 years old, in his sixth major league season,
corre, corre, corre.
He and his wife Beatrix and son Randy are enjoying life in San Diego.
No, bájate.
Renting a house in the South Bay with a view across the border to Mexico, although his roots are in South America, Caracas, Venezuela. Born Ramon Jose Hernandez Marin, May 27, 1976, his mother was a social worker, his father a supervisor for a computer company. While his younger twin brothers had no interest in sports, Ramon loved volleyball, soccer, and his father's favorite game, baseball.
He was like, if you want to be a baseball player someday, it's going to be hard, it's not going to be easy, and if you want to do that, you know what I mean, you just got to be ready for it.
Youth baseball in Venezuela is organized mostly by company-sponsored teams to give poor kids a positive alternative to the streets.
Did you ever get in trouble?
I mean, I got in trouble a lot. And I used to be, you know, go on the street and fight a lot and with my friend. You know, when you got a bunch of friends, talking about we like 14, 15, 16 years old, trying to be grown men.
Unlike some of his friends who ended up in trouble or dead, Hernandez chose to leave the rough street scene to focus on sports. By 1994, at 17 years old, he was playing shortstop and the outfield, and one day a scout from the Oakland A's wanted to see him in action, including as a catcher, something Ramon hadn't done for 5 years.
It's like, can you squat down for me? So I squat down, so I throw the ball easy, and you throw the second. Do you know how to go faster? Yeah, I know how to go faster. So go faster, go faster. So it's like, can you practice this for like a month, 2 months, and then come back later and see you how you do? So yeah, go ahead.
2 months later, the scout returned, liked what he saw, and signed him for $5,000. But summer league in the Dominican was about learning to catch and building the field where they played.
That was a lot of work.
Were you thinking, this is not what I signed up for?
Yeah. Yeah, especially when I was building the field. I was like, I just signed here, I guess, to play baseball. And then, I was cleaning bathrooms, living rooms, building grass, and soon as like about 8 o'clock, your eyes just falling closed because you were so tired that you just couldn't do nothing else.
The incentive, work hard so as to not return the next year. As for knowing English?
It was very difficult.
Yeah.
I mean, they teach you the basics and stuff, but I just still couldn't get it. And I was thinking to myself, when am I going to need English for? And the day when I got to the United States, I was like, that's what I need English for.
When he arrived in Arizona for rookie league.
What was the most surprising thing when you first came to the United States? What?
I must say that how nice the city and clean. The first thing was when you drive on the street, you don't have no horns. Because in Venezuela and Latin countries, you had a lot of horns when you're driving your car.
A lot of horns.
Yeah, that's a lot of hurry up or move. Or, I mean, you got to have some, you know, trying to be quick to be the other one.
Right.
If it's somebody hurting, that means he's an emergency or something.
He did well on the field, the MVP of the rookie league, but living on $50 a week meal money.
I mean, one time I was thinking to quit.
So. Really?
Yeah, because like, I wasn't seeing anything out of this. So I was like, and I'm almost playing for free. And I want to get my family at least trying to live a little bit better. But you know, I got, I mean, thanks, my friends, my mother, my father, and I got good people around me. They're like, you know, you got to go through this. You got to go through this, and everybody's going to go through that. So that's going to teach you how to be a grown man. So that did. That area teach me when you're really going through a part time of your life, that's when you got to be taught to yourself if you're ready for it or not.
By the next year, he'd have another eye-opener, playing with the West Michigan Whitecaps, recalling the first time he had ever seen snow.
Get out of the bus and it's cold and like, what is this? And I look down, you see the snow, so that's ice, so I come out and touch it. Trying to grab it, I couldn't believe what it was. And I mean, all my friends, they were the same thing, man, it's cold in here. So we asked him, how long is it gonna take? They're like, might take like a month and a half, 2 months. I said, we gotta play in this? The funnest part, we was winning. So I mean, you're winning and we got a championship, you know, I mean, the cold weather got away. We start having some fun.
Mixed in with that, meeting Beatrix, 2 years older, back in Venezuela. She had grown up playing and watching baseball there, and her brother, Juan Moreno, played with Ramon through single A.
I was in the college when I met Ramon in the Caracas Stadium. And that's it. I just saw him and I feel my love for him.
As for her hopes for his career then?
I don't care if it's Manoli, Bailey. He has so many, you know, worry about that. He always gonna be up and up and up, but I'm fine whatever he do.
A league-leading hitter, he moved through the minors, landing in AAA Vancouver in 99. That June, an injury on the A's roster created an opening, and a 1 a.m. phone call informed him he'd be going to the majors.
So I don't know what to do. I was like, you happy? I was like, I'm just nervous now.
You're nervous.
You know, I was nervous. And then...
His anxiety about whether he'd stay in the majors seemed to be for not making a splash from the start.
What a play by Ramon Hernandez, known as a slugger in the minor leagues, and he picks up his first major league hit with a bunt single.
Did you surprise yourself?
Yeah, I did. After 2000 season, when it was my first full season that we won our division for like half a game, I was pretty excited. I was like, it's unbelievable. Now we're going to the playoff. You see everybody was jumping, like, I mean, you see grown men jumping like a little kid.
Up next on One-on-One, Ramon's experience in the playoffs with the Padres and parenthood. And later, the adventures of Ryan Klesko and his new pad by the ballpark. Starting mid-season 1999, Ramon Hernandez, at just 23 years old, was behind the plate with experienced pitchers.
What did you do to communicate with them and to learn that? Because that's a lot of responsibility for a young guy.
Yeah, it's a lot of work. The pitching coach was in Oakland. He was number one that put me where I am about calling games. I watch a lot of videos. I spent hours and hours watching videos. And the opposite team hitters.
It's a strike him out, throw him out, inning ending double play.
You got to do it because the guys are there pitching as his career also. If we win together. If we lose together.
His ambition went beyond his A's uniform. He played for Venezuela during Winter League, a standout in the Caribbean World Series in 2000. While with Oakland, Ramon Hernandez broke and set records for the team, including league-leading starts behind the plate. Offensively, he became only the fifth catcher in A's history to hit 20 home runs in a season.
For a grand slam! On Hernandez, and he hits one hard to left center field.
His numbers often putting him among the best among all major league catchers.
Knocks the ball free.
He made some errors and allowed more than the average number of stolen bases, but his consistency was impressive.
Out at home plate.
And in 2003, Ramon was named to his first American League All-Star team.
Catcher Ramon Hernandez.
His contributions helped the A's get to the postseason 4 years in a row.
Getting just to the brink, but never quite to the ultimate prize.
It was frustrating. It was a lot of frustration, especially last year. Because the first year we made the playoff, and nobody was expecting that we got a chance to make the playoff.
From postseason underdogs to favorites, the A's lost each time in the first round.
Strike three called, and the Boston Red Sox have come from behind.
We never put our head down because we know we're trying to hide us. And we can't get it done. I guess it wasn't for us.
But Ramon Hernandez was a good fit for the San Diego Padres, who had been through several catchers in their rebuilding years, shocked by the trade at first.
I couldn't wait till a spring training start.
This guy, they got a new stadium. We're going to have new uni. So I guess when you have it all that, it's like a little kid with new toy.
Excited. Was nervous.
Yeah,
very
nervous.
Yeah. And especially the first day I woke up to the clubhouse. When I woke in and I looked down first, I was like, no more white shoes.
No more white shoes.
No white shoes. It was all black. And I'm like, wow, this is another team.
Different league?
Different league. And you got to learn everything new. It's everything new. Hitters, pitchers, when you hit.
A lot would be expected of him.
At first, I was like a little worried about that. I was like, these people are expecting a lot from me. And sometimes, you know, you get pressure because I'm human, so me and but now I just get to know these guys and we get to know each other very, very, very good, and I get to know how they like to pitch each guy because each one is different.
He has adjusted.
Not to put any pressure on you, but I think a lot of people think of 1998 and we think that we had another catcher named Hernandez who was from Venezuela, Carlos Hernandez. Do you ever?
People are still calling me Carlos around here.
People are calling you Carlos.
Yeah, sometimes. This last year, Carlos. I'm like, I'm in Oakland again, Carlos. And I come here, I totally again, Carlos. So I'm like, I guess, you know, me, Carlos left just, I like that. I like it because that means he left a good, he left here a good thing out of his name. He do
good impression.
Good impression of himself. And when I see that other people, I'm proud of him.
Do you ever look back and think when you were that little kid in Venezuela, you look at some of those pictures of you in your little baseball uniform and you see where you are now?
Yeah, all the time. I remember when I was 15, I don't even have a car, nothing. I don't have a car, I don't have a house, I don't have anything. I don't even have like $2 in my pocket. I was dependent on my family and you know, we don't wasn't rich either. Now I have cars and you have houses, but to me, that's the material thing don't count. I always like to be Ramon, and I always like to be the people knows me and the people want me is not because I'm a guy the uniform. I want the people want me when I'm out the field and not because I'm playing the big leagues.
With his success and a nearly $3 million a year salary, he gives back. Sponsoring a little league team in Caracas, and as part of the Padres community outreach, helping charities who help kids.
I will do it because I'm a father, and I know how it feels, how desperate it gets when you see your son sick or hurt.
Beatrix would like to use her sociology degree to work with children or women in need someday. She's working on her English too.
Con todas las oportunidades que me da el béisbol.
Sí, sí, yo entendí eso. Uh-huh. I understand
that. ¿Qué sientes tú? ¿Qué?
And with another baby on the way, she's thankful for their baseball and American dream.
I'm so very happy with this country, with his opportunities. I know so many people want to live my life, but I miss my family, I miss my country. It's hard. It's hard when you by yourself in another country. But you can be a better life. So it's, you know, it's the, I don't know how
balance.
You say.
The balance.
Yeah, it's the balance.
How has fatherhood changed him? How is he different now that he's a dad?
You know what? He's like another boy too. He always, when I don't have baby, he say like, Ramon is like a baby. And he don't change really. And he's like, I have three kids and now he has company for you, for his, you know, playing and... It's like, okay, that is what I need, company for his doing his stuff, and he's like another baby. He played with the Randy, and Randy don't go up to Ramon. Ramon go down to Randy. And I feel like
true?
I have two babies now.
As for playing with the big boys, Ramon Hernandez gives it his all.
Get him!
While a June collision at the plate pulls him out of the game with a strained knee.
Oh, no.
His intensity and passion should give Padres fans reason to feel much like he does.
You're walking into a nice stadium, you want to play. And especially with these fans lately, they've been going to the game. So when you see the stadium, a lot of fans on it, they pump you up. You want to go out and play and try to win.
When Ryan Klesko first came to the San Diego Padres, he was a bit of a mystery, a tough guy slugger known for his legendary SWAT team excursions. To find out more about the guy with the varying facial hair designs, we spent time with him in the winter of 2000 on his land near Atlanta with a big log cabin he bought while playing with the Braves.
So I'm a normal person. I play baseball. I'm not anybody special.
We found he is adventurous and generous, reasons he quickly became a fan favorite. That home is still his southern connection, but his West Coast home is now in La Jolla with an ocean view.
I didn't grow up with a whole lot of money, so
right.
I'm very fortunate, and it's just exciting for me to be able to play in the major leagues and give back. I think that's what excites me the most, is to be able to give back and do things for other people.
This house again reveals the many facets of the Southern California native, starting at his driveway.
After I made the All-Star team, that was my little
bonus, I've been trying to find since I was a kid. I wanted a 21 window bus with a rag top, and I, right after I made the team, I was in Anaheim. I opened up the Auto Trader and found it and went and bought it.
First baseman Ryan Plesko.
That all-star selection in 2001 was the first of his career so far. A career that began in Orange County, pitching to his mom from a makeshift mound. The Westminster High School grad was drafted by Atlanta, then with the Braves for 3 World Series. The Padres liked all that and traded for him after the 99 season. He'd be a key part during the team's rebuilding years, which had unexpected ballpark delays, low payroll, lots of trades.
It's tough when you go to the ballpark later in the season, last few years, when you're down 15, 20 games and you got no chance to even. It's hard to play like that, it really is. We did have some good clubs, and honestly, going into every spring training since I've been with the club, I always felt that we always had a chance to win it.
Ryan Plesko did his part, the team MVP in 2002, and accepting moves from first to right to first to left.
I guess I'm one of those guys that's versatile. Versatile. So just, you know, like since when it comes down, when we think about it, it's not about where I want to play. It's all about winning and getting back.
Even with nagging injuries, he had mostly avoided the disabled list and major surgery until a shoulder operation at the end of 2003. And then a strained rib muscle causing him to miss nearly a month in the first half of 2004. Still, Ryan Plesko attributes his longevity in the majors to his many interests, staying active, in shape, year-round.
You like to be ready for whatever situation.
Yeah, right? If the waves are small, you need a longer board. If they're short, you need a shorter board. And for big fish, you need big poles. For small fish, you need small poles.
There you go. Plus, if you bring friends along, you want them to be prepared, right? And what about these motorcycles here?
Well, I got this made custom bike. I love riding motorcycles, and I had the Rhino painted. I always asked my nickname, I had the Rhino painted on.
Hunting is on the list. Take our excursion with him back that cold winter day in Georgia.
All right, let's roll.
And in the still of the early morning.
I mean, it froze up solid. It might not be good.
Ryan Plesko is in his element.
Aren't you glad you got up early this morning? We ain't seen nothing but one duck. Think how pretty that hawk is. There is some ice on the pond. We're out here in the hardwood timber and pines, and it's more the camaraderie and getting out and just getting away from work and the city and everything.
Do you do things a little differently, or maybe not take quite as many risks as maybe you used to in terms of your body physically?
Oh yeah, definitely. A lot of this stuff is just kind of casual stuff. I quit the SWAT team a few years ago.
Well,
since I came over from Atlanta, I don't go out with the SWAT team and do raids and stuff anymore, and bulletproof vests and run down drug dealers and stuff. So I guess I'm slowing down a little bit, you know, and I'm not really surfing a whole lot during the season. Maybe once in a while I'll get out and catch a couple waves and get loose and stuff like that, and you know, but I think that's what's gotten me here.
You're very eclectic.
Yeah. Sanford and Son.
Is that what you'd say?
I've always been fascinated by Babe Ruth, and then we've got the karaoke machine over there, and sometimes we'll do disco, and Babe will join us. Babe joins us, and he starts to disco out. I got his little disco glasses, and he enjoys it.
This is a little controversial. Barry Bonds is living in Ryan Plesko's house. What is up with that?
How about that? Another charity auction. In my opinion, the best player that's ever played the game. I mean, I've been playing basically during the same time he has, and I mean, obviously, I didn't get to see some of those other guys played, and I had a chance to get that, and you know, and he's always been nice to me and everything, and it's just something I do collect a lot of stuff. So actually, when he comes in town next, if he's in a good mood, I'm gonna have him sign that. Well, Coco, I've had for a couple years, and you know.
Can you talk, Coco?
Oh, she mimics me. Now we're coming to the dungeon. When I got the house, you know, I figured if I was gonna wine store, I better start collecting wine. And now I've got boxes laying all over, so I need more room or more racks, or I don't know what I'm gonna do.
After a stop in the movie theater, he showed us his other vice, or a hobby, in the closet.
I do have a lot of shoes.
A lot of shoes. Oh my gosh, have you counted?
No, I haven't. Over the years. I love to shop for shoes on the road. And that's a bad thing. I mean,
wear them?
I have a lot of clothes.
It's very you. The house is very you. I mean, it's...
You should see when my country friends come. They don't think it's me. I got a really? Log... You've been to the log home. Go from log home to this.
If home is where the heart is, Ryan Klesko has a lot of heart. Honored with the first local Lifetime Achievement Award by the Make-A-Wish Foundation for his dedication to kids with life-threatening conditions.
I've been blessed to be able to play this game and be able to give back with my Make-A-Wish kids. And I can't, you know, it's been great and take care of my family and I can't ask for any more.
Including sharing with his mom his new luxury metropolitan condo at the Omni next door to Petco Park.
She's extra special, so it's nice to be able to do something for like this for her.
Let's check out
it's
the views.
Beautiful, oh yeah. And you can actually, half the time it's hard to get my friends and family to leave here because they can watch the game from right here. This condo costs more than my whole place in Georgia, which is 250 acres with three houses on it.
Really?
Yeah. It's San Diego, though. San Diego, Georgia doesn't have this beautiful weather and doesn't have the ocean right here and the ballpark's in right here either.
That's right.
So I'm glad that you came out and did a little checkup on me, and it's always nice to see you.
Ryan Klesko is simply a class act.
You know, I don't know how long I'm going to play. I don't know if I'm going to play. I got 3 years left on my contract, and we'll see from there. But I'm just enjoying it now. And like I said, I'm back home close to my family, and I have a lot of great friends, and just excited about everything.
This is where I want to be. Right here with my loved ones.
Ramon Hernandez and Ryan Klesko, two guys on the Padres who are not only valued for their everyday contributions on the field, but because they know what it's like to be where the Padres want to go, the postseason. I'm Jane Mitchell. Thank you for watching One on One.